Hello, fellow coders out there, and welcome to part 4 in my series on how to make a fishing game here on Scratch. Now, so far, we've made a main menu screen, we've made a game over screen, a score mechanism, and a lives mechanism. And in this tutorial, we're going to be making a settings mechanism, background audio, we're going to be adding a shop system, a level up system, and a lot of cool other features as well. So without further ado, let's get into this! Here I am in the fishing game project that we've been working on in the last few tutorials. Now, I know it's been a long time since I posted the last tutorial, so what I figured I was going to do is I'm going to go over all the code because it will hopefully jog your memory and hopefully ring some bells. So first sprite that I'm going to go over is this boat sprite. And there's not much code to go over here. All the code that's in this boat sprite is the if game ID equals 2, then show else hide. And if you remember from the last tutorial, the game ID is the governor for what mode the game is going to be in. So 2 meant the game ID is in this game state. And actually, since there's no code in this boat sprite, I'm actually just going to select all by doing Command A or Control A if you're on Windows. Then I'm copying it, which is Command C or Command V, Command C or Control C on Windows. And you just paste it in here, and you bring it up there. Let's see if that fits. Actually doesn't fit that well, so let me just adjust that. And actually I might wanna group this because, yeah. And that looks a lot better. And the reason I put the boat sprite in the backdrop is because we're not gonna be doing any code to the boat, so that's why I put it in the backdrop. It's more like a decorative sprite than anything. And I can get rid of this boat sprite. Now, the second sprite that I'm going to talk about is this fishing hook sprite. Now, this sprite is essential because this is what is going to bring us points to the game. And let me just go over this code real quick. So, this code basically says, like, when go click set size to 17, so it's always going to reset this fishing hook to this size. And we run into a loop. Now this loop controls the, if you press a down arrow or up arrow, then it will go down or up. And that's why we put the costume center around the top of the fishing hook. Because if we put it at the center, if we did that, then it wouldn't work. So we obviously had to put the costume center at the top of the fishing hook. That's the only way this code will work. And obviously we have this code, which just makes it show when the game is run. Then we have this fish code right here, which, this code, it basically resets all of the variables. Now I'm going to be changing this code later, but for now, that's that. This code resets all the variables, sets the score and the lives to 0. It sets score to 0 and sets lives to 5. It sets the ghost effect to 0. It sets the size to 40 because it would be too big. It would be too big if it was at 100 size. It sets the color effect to a random color effect because we want some variety in the fish. It's going to switch costume to the random little or big. Then it's going to go to a random Y position of the fish Y paws. And if you remember here, these are all the possible fish Y paws it could go. So here, here, so here, 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 or here. Now this is a code that just spawns the fish. And this is the code where the score plays. And we're going to be changing this code in a bit. You already know what this code does. Now let's move on to the timer sprite. And the timer is actually quite self-explanatory. But only if the game ID equals 2, then change the timer by -1. We will change this wait time, guys. In our level up, when we do the level up code, we're going to change this wait time according to what level is going to be. And also the timer, obviously. You can make it larger or smaller based on how easy or hard you want the game to be. And then here's start menu, which we worked on in the last tutorial. This is the algorithm that I talked about in that tutorial. And I actually want to change this to be timer -1. It's a neat trick I picked up. And also in this one, I'll also timer minus one. Cool. And the start menu basically shows if the game ID equals one. And I actually changed the script a little bit. Instead of being if mouse down, I changed it to if key access pressed. The reason I didn't do it if mouse down is because I ran into some odd glitches when I did the mouse down. So I just had to switch that to key access was pressed. And we're going to be working on this press S for settings in this tutorial, but that's that for the start screen sprite. And for the game over screen sprite, it's the same thing, but it only shows if the lives is less than one. If the game ID equals three. Then let's move into the live sprite. I can actually delete this. I don't see why I need it. X. It works fine without it, but this basically switches the costume to the lives, and we have that lives costume right there. Now we have the restart. Button. Now the reason I took out the restart, the restart text from the game over was because of some odd glitches again I was getting. So I had to move the restart text into its own button. So I did the same algorithm for that, and in fact, I'll do timer minus two. Bit of variety. Now, for this restart button, I did this actually off screen, so you might want to copy this code in. I'll give you a few seconds to copy this code. Okay, you've copied that code, right? Now let's move on to the main menu button. Unlike the restart button, which sets the game ID to 2, the main menu button sets the game ID to 1, which will bring you back to the main menu. So now that we have got that covered, we can move on to the stage where I've done some code, or I've done some changes here too. So when go clicked, obviously set game ID to 1, and I can put this in here. And I have, let's talk about this one first. When go clicked, set game ID to 1. Then we go to a loop. We say if game ID equals 3, show these variables. Otherwise, hide these variables. And that's for the game over screen. Let's just speed up this timer real quick. And as you can see, the score and the high score show right there. So let's just set the timer back to 30. And let's go back to the stage, and that's what that code does. Now this code is actually a bit different. It actually, if score is greater than high score, set the high score to score. This is basically updating the high score whenever the score surpasses high score, if that makes any sense. And as you can see, I've changed this script up a little bit. So as you know, in the previous tutorials, there's a joint score variable. But I actually didn't like the way the joint score variable looked. It looked kind of odd. So instead of having it be score colon space joint score, or sorry, score colon space the score variable, I had it be a join, a couple of joins, actually three joins, but I had it be cash colon space, then a dollar sign, then score, but then after that I did dot zero zero. And that makes, and all this code is this right here. So, I like the way that looked, so I kept it like that. And now let's get into actually programming the new features that I talked about today. All right, now let's get some background music. Now, unfortunately, I don't own this, so I cannot give it to you, but what I can give you is a music bank that's here on Scratch that has a really wide range of music that you can choose from. It's called the Vexento Music Bank. I'll link in the description down below. But with that said, let me choose my sound by going to the sounds tab, grabbing it from my backpack, and this is the one. So let me first listen to it, see if it sounds good. Yep, it sounds good. So well, we're going to do some coding on this sound because right now it doesn't do anything. It's not in our code yet. It's only in the sound library. So let's actually do some coding on this. All right, first thing that we're going to be doing is we're going to be, first of all, getting a when go clicked. Then we're going to be getting forever, going to sound, play sound teeth until done. see it works perfectly. We can get that sound.
Some days you're the only.
Oh, I gotta lower my volume. It's really loud right now. And as you can see, the background music is playing. And we can play our game perfectly.
Some days you're the only thing I'm.
So, yeah, that's for the background audio. Now let's get the settings mechanism where we can actually, actually manipulate the sound's volumes. Because right now, we can't manipulate the sound in any way, and there's this press S for settings. It doesn't do anything right now, so that's what we need to work on right now. So, okay, first thing that we're gonna do is go to the start menu, duplicate this script because that's, the settings is gonna be identical to the press X to begin, but instead of if key X is pressed, we're gonna have if key S is pressed. And instead of game ID to 4, to 2, we're gonna set game ID to 4, and that's gonna be the settings screen. So, if we do it right now, as you can see, it brings us to that, to an empty screen, where, and obviously that's not what we want. We want the music, we want the actual settings to appear on there. So I think I'm going to be having a music option over here and a lag option over here, where we can turn on the, where we can turn off the music or turn off the lag or turn on and turn on. So how do we do that? First of all, we need to paint a new sprite. We need to press this and we need to obviously make some text for the music and put it right there. And this is gonna belong right there. And we're actually gonna code the music before we code the lag so that it's a lot easier down in the long run. So we're actually gonna duplicate this script. We're gonna put it right in there. And we're gonna say if game ID equals 4, then where are we gonna go? We're gonna set X to -121 and set Y to, I don't know why I have a minus here. It's really supposed to be a plus. Plus 54, perfect. So, what this is gonna do is it's gonna float up and down like that. And I actually want it to be 200. S, so you can see it's working. And yeah, it looks pretty good. Now let's add the button where if you click it, it's going to turn off the volume. So if you paint a new sprite, you can make a very quick button right here. I'm obviously doing a very bad job. I'm not the best artist out there, but I'm just gonna have to live with that. Let's make a really cheesy music logo. That looks pretty good. I'm gonna rename this to on. And I will duplicate this, I'll rename this off, and I will just draw a line through there. Cool. Now that we have our costume, we can duplicate. Sometimes that happens, this menu gets in the way, and you can't copy scripts. So we'll duplicate this to here. And if game ID is 121. That's perfect, but obviously the button doesn't do anything yet. So what we're gonna say is we're gonna do a bit of code where if we click it, then it'll switch the costume. However, we don't just want to click it and have it have no effect whatsoever when we mouse over it, because obviously we want an effect when we mouse over it. And I've covered this at length in my previous video. So go check it out. The link is in the I over here. So click that. But I'm just going to go over. I'm just going to do this code real quick. The mouse over code. So I'm going to say when go clicked forever. If touching mouse pointer. Oh, mouse pointer. Create a lot of sprites so far. if touching mouse pointer, then we're gonna make a new variable called ghost effect. And we're gonna hide that. We're going to, first of all, set ghost effect to, we're gonna set this ghost effect to ghost effect variable. Now we can do this algorithm. Change ghost effect by, minus ghost effect divided by 3. Now we're gonna duplicate this, put that in the else, 0. Now, as you can see, it works. It lowers the opacity a little bit. And again, I talked about this at length in a previous video, so go check the description or click the I to get more information on this topic. Alright, now let's get the mechanism where if you click it, it switches costume. Okay. For this, we're gonna need to make a variable called volume. Oh, I already have a variable named volume, so just delete that. We need to make a variable called volume. And, let's see. What are we gonna do? We're going to make a new variable called volume on or off. And then what we're gonna do is we're going to say, let's see. If mouse down, then we're gonna get another if else inside of that if. If mouse down, if else. We're gonna get an equals. If volume on or off equals on, then what we're gonna do is set volume on or off to off. Then we're gonna set else, we're gonna set volume on or off to on. So that works. And let's see if it works so far. So if we press this, then this should change. Oh, we actually want to say wait until, not mouse down. That's a common mistake people do, even me, apparently. So that works. So you can see that works. And obviously at the start of the game, we want to set volume on or off to on, because obviously the volume will be on at the start of the game. And we can delete this. S, as you can see, we can mouse over, we have that nice little effect, and as you can see, volume on or off goes on or off. Perfect. Now, now let's get the lag. We can't work on the lag right now. We have to, before we work on the lag, we actually have to switch the costumes. Switch costume to off, switch costume to on. We actually need a variable called volume, because that's gonna, I really don't. We can just use the built-in volume variables that they have. Set volume to 0 if it's off, then set volume to, let's try 75 if it's on. And we can hide this. So.
Some days you're.
The music is coming from the stage, so we need this volume variable to connect to the actual volume. We're gonna set this volume to the volume variable, and then we're going to we need to actually get rid of these. And we need to say when go clicked forever if music on or off, volume on or off equals on, then we're gonna set volume on or off to off. Obviously. Wait, that's not what we want to do. How do we do this? We actually want to include these. Set volume on or off to off, and set volume on or off to on. A much easier way to do this is, instead of this sound being played in the stage, we could just have this sound being played in the button. So we can say when go clicked forever, play sound teeth until done. So now we can set the volume to 0 and set volume to 75 and it'll actually work. Whew, sorry about that. Let me explain it because that was a bit confusing. So basically what this entire script does is it basically sets volume on or off to on, obviously, because music is on. Then it sets the volume to, then it sets the ghost effect to the ghost effect variable, and then if touching mouse pointer, it does the algorithm, that smoothing algorithm. If it's not, then it gradually fades back to where it was. It hires the opacity, it makes the opacity go higher. Then if the mouse is down, meaning if we're clicking on it, then we do this code. Now this code is where the tricky bit is. If the volume on or off is on, now what this is basically a toggle variable where it can only be 1 or 0, on or off. It's what's called a Boolean variable. And this is basically gonna tell us, like, hey, is the music on or is it off? So if it's on, if it's on and the mouse is down, obviously we wanted to turn it off, right? So we turn it off, we set the volume to 0, switch the costume to off, then set volume on or off to off. However, if once we've done this and we want the music to be back on, it sets the volume back to 75, and it switches the costume to on, sets the volume on or off to on, and obviously this script is so that it doesn't just, it's that you can't just hold it once and it just automatically switches from on and off. Whew, that's a bit of a mouthful. Let's see if it works. And as you can see, it works perfectly.
Some days you're the...
Now, there is supposed to be a back button. However, there is none. Like, as you can see in my script, actually, before we do the back button, let's actually set this volume to 75 because, yeah. Oh, wait. Yeah, set volume to 75. And we need to switch costume to on, apparently. And as you can see, it works perfectly. Now let's work on the back button because, as you can see, if we go to the settings, we turn it off, turn it on again. There's no way to return back unless we can go into code and set the game ID to 1. That's obviously not a good way to return back to the main menu. So we need a back button. And to do that, we can just duplicate this and rename this back. And as you can see, we can just type back. And boom. We can draw a little graphic here that represents it back. And yeah, as you can see, that's how it works. So we can actually put the back button right here. And because we duplicated it from the main menu button, the back button will have almost similar scripts to what we want it to be. The only problem is we want it to show when the game rate equals 4. And we want to set x to -177, set y to 148. Gotta change this to a plus. So, and if the game rate equals 4, if touching mouse pointer and mouse down, set game rate to 1. We don't need this. So as you can see, it works now. We have a nice little back button right there. And we can make this 200.
Some days you're the only thing I know.
500.
Only thing that's
burning.
That's
too fast. 200.
Cold. Can't look
nice.
Away.
Turn off the music. Nice. We have our back button. Now let's get the lag mechanism. I should turn off this music, man. Okay, now let's get the lag mechanism. Actually, I'll save that for a later video. Yeah, I'll save the lag for a later video, but right now, let's get working on the fun stuff, which is the shop system. Let's get started. Alright, now let's get started working on the shop system. Now, I'm just going to speed up this making of the graphics, because I don't want to take up any more of your time, so I'll just speed this up while I make the graphics. Okay, so now I'm done making the art for the power-ups. Now let's actually add some functionality to these power-ups, because right now they don't do anything, we can't collect them or anything. So let's actually get started with making them function in the game. So the shop system effectively is going to be a little button over here in the main game screen where you can click it and it'll bring you to this power-ups. So first hide this. Mute this, and then press X to begin. I was thinking that the shop system could go right there. The shop button could go right there. So we can say duplicate this back button, get rid of this stuff, and rename this to be shop. Yup, that seems pretty good. It's gonna be a smaller button than the rest. So I'm just going to have it be a little tiny button right there. And show, I'll probably have it somewhere over here where we can see it nice and easily. Cool. Now, we want this actually to be at totally different coordinates, so 152. And we can make this be timer minus 1. So, we want this shop button effectively to bring us to the shop screen. And when the game ID equals 2, then show if touching mouse pointer and mouse down, set the game ID to 5, because that's going to be the shop system. And we're going to rename this shop. Okay. Now we're going to say when go clicked forever if the game ID equals 5. Then what we're going to do is we're going to show else hide, and we're also going to go to 00. It's really important. And as you can see, it works. However, there's no movement whatsoever. So what we need to do is we need to add some movement in. We can just bring this here. I don't feel like redoing the entire algorithm all over again, so I'm just copying and pasting code at this point, because all good programmers are lazy. So let's see, shop. Huh. I wonder why the shop's not working. Oh, we need if the game ID equals 2. As you can see, it works. As you can see, now if we press the shop, we can't collect the power-ups yet, but at least the power-ups show. So what we're going to do next is we're going to get it so that you can actually buy the power-ups. So let's get this faster fishhook speed first. And for that, we need to go into the fishing hook sprite and make a few variables. Let's see, one called hook speed. And hide this. We're gonna first set hook speed sorry. First, we're going to set the hook speed to 3, and we're going to change x by hook speed in this one, and we're going to change x by hook speed times -1 in this one. So as you can see, if we mute this because it's super annoying, and if we do that, wait, I don't know why I'm going to the power-ups when I'm just testing out the hook speed. Sorry about that. Let me just check the hook speed. As you can see, the hook speed's 3. The fishing hook works as normal. Now, the reason this is good is because we can actually change the hook speed when we want to upgrade to the faster hook speed, if that makes any sense. So what was the price for the faster hook speed? $50. Cool. Okay, we can say here that we can actually say in this script only, if the score is greater than 50, and we're going to set the hook speed to, let's see now, 7? I think that's a good one. Otherwise, we're going to set the hook speed to 3. Cool. Now let's see if that works. As you can see, it works. We have way faster hook speed now. We're catching those bottom fish. Dang it. Anything that's burning when the nights grow cold. Nice. Can't look away, can't look away. We have the easiest of the power-ups, but it can also act as a negative. So that's why I put it at the lowest pricing for the power-ups. Now, for the next two power-ups, I'm going to be working on them in the next tutorial. But tune in for that, because in the next tutorial, I'm also going to be working on a boss. So, I guess now let's work on the level up system. Alright, now for the level up system, we're going to be doing something a bit different. Because unlike for practically all of the code in this fishing game, nothing has been in custom blocks. And that's obviously not what I want. I mean, I want the code to be nice and organized, and one way of doing that is using custom blocks. I mean, it may seem more advanced, but it's really not. Like, let me give you a demonstration. So we have all of this code, right? All of this code, and only to just reset everything. So what if we made a variable called reset? Oh, sorry, what if we made a custom block called reset? Don't worry about this run without screen refresh. We're not going to be doing that for the purposes of simplicity. But what if we replaced every single one of this code with reset, and all we did was say reset, when go click to reset and spawn new fish? I mean, we've not changed anything. I mean, the only thing we've changed is the efficiency, and that too, we're making it more efficient. But watch what it does to the code. It actually makes it a lot cleaner while serving the same function. Now, this is a really good way to clean up your programs, because I've seen a lot of people's code really, really basic, but very soon they start to get messy, and that's because they're not using custom blocks to clean up the code. And especially if you use inputs in custom blocks, it starts to become really clean, because you can just plug in the input, and that's a lot cleaner than doing all this code out. Now, with that said, we're going to create another custom block called level check, and we're going to click OK. Now, in this level check, we're basically going to say all the checkpoints, all the levels to where we want to go. But to do that, we need to create a variable called level, which I already have created. And what we're going to do is we'll go to the stage later, but for now, we're just going to get the level check custom block all figured out. And Let's get started with making the level check custom block. We're going to say if the level equals 1, then we're going to set the fish speed to 3. So as you can see, if the level is equal to 1, then we're going to set the fish speed to 3, and that's just the normal level, okay? That's the normal level, that's the level that we've been playing all along. Now, the rest of the levels may seem a bit subjective, and I really want you to play around with these to find out what works best for you, but I'm just going to speed things up a little bit, just to give you a little bit more freedom on your levels and your fish speed. So let me speed it up right now, and I'll come back to you when I'm somewhere near finished. Okay, and I'm just getting done with doing the 10, level 10, where the fish speed equals 100, I mean. But just know that this is entirely subjective and only my opinion. And obviously, you can do different levels and different fish speed, and you can do a different number of levels. And there's of course a more efficient way of doing this. But the last time I did this efficient way, I ran into some glitches. So this is just the best way I found I can do it. This is obviously not efficient, but it's just the best way I found I can do it. So now let's actually get the mechanism where if the score reaches a certain point, then we change levels. So what we're gonna say is, again, I'm gonna speed this up real quick because, again, this is kind of subjective. So yeah. Okay, so as you can see, I'm all finished with the checkpoints, and again, this is very subjective, and I don't want to kind of force your opinions on you. I just want to give you freedom to, like, do whatever you want to do. And let's see if it works. Let's just show the level.
Some days you're the only thing I know. Only thing that's burning when the nights grow cold. Can't look away, can't look away.
beg you to stay, beg you to stay, yeah. Sometimes you're a stranger in my bed. Don't know if you love me or you want me dead. Some days you're the only thing I know. Only thing that's burning when the nights grow cold.
Okay, so it doesn't seem to quite want to work. And let's see why that is. I don't know if it's... let's see what the problem is. I don't see a problem. Let me, it doesn't seem to want to work, and that's because... let's actually put this, let's actually put all of this code in, let's actually put all this fish YPOS code in here, and let's put show, obviously, and it should work. I don't know, it's not working. Oh! We need to put this in the stage, that's why. Yeah, it's... Let's see. I don't think it's... It's the same problem I was having. Let's see the fish speed. The fish speed is 3, and why is that? The fish speed should be moving faster and faster and faster, but for some reason it isn't. Actually, let me try to figure out what's going on here. I will come back to you when I'm somewhere, when I've figured out this weird glitch. Yeah, I think I figured out my problem. It's, I defined the level check, but I never actually called this level check. So yeah, that's why you need to always call your functions whenever you use them, because if you don't, you're gonna get something unexpected like I just did right there. So as you can see, let's see if this works now. Let's first of all show the level variable and the fish speed variable, because I wanna see if this actually works. Some days you're the only thing I know. As you can see, it works. The fish speed gets a lot faster. Burning when the nights grow cold. Can't look away. Oh, whoa. That's getting really fast. Okay. So, we are... That seems to fix the problem. Now, let me... actually, there's one more feature that I wanted to add. I promise. Just one more. And that's the plastic bottle feature. Now, so far, what we've made... is a little fish and a big fish, and these two increase the score. But have you ever thought of having a plastic bottle in the ocean that decreases the lives of the player? And I actually thought of this. Actually, a fan gave me the idea. A friend gave me the idea of adding a plastic bottle. So I really liked the idea. So I added it into my demo project, and I figured I just had to add it in this project as well. So let me just add a plastic bottle real quick. Now it looks like more of a perfume bottle, but it's fine. It's all fine. Everything's fine. Okay, cool. Cool, cool, cool. It's all fine and dandy and stuff. It's actually a bit too small, but I'll just let it live with that. Well, let's just rename this plastic bottle. And, yeah. Don't throw a plastic bottle in the ocean, guys. Please don't. It's ruining the wildlife in the sea. Just don't do it. It will make you lose a life in this game. That's the reason why. Just don't put plastic bottle in the ocean. Please! It contributes to global warming as well. Change lives by -1, and we're also going to play a sound. And play this one. For some reason, I really like this one for wrong sound effects. I was like, uh-oh, plastic bottle. Okay. We're gonna start sound, uh-oh, plastic bottle, and then, yeah. So now, as you can see, they should spawn. Oh! They won't spawn because I never set them to spawn. As remember here, I said switch costume, pick random 1 to 2. We actually want this to be 1 to 3, so yeah. So now they should spawn often. Oh, what happened here? I actually want to just get rid of these, all these blocks temporarily because... Oh, there you go. As you can see, a plastic ball spawns right there. As you can see, if we collect that, we lose a life and it plays its sound. So, yeah. Oh, and one more thing we have to add to the game. We have to first click scene side. And then we have to add this code and not costume number equals 3 to this repeat until. If we don't do this, then every time the plastic bottle touches the edge, we're also going to lose a life. And we don't want to do that. We only want to lose a life if the costume number... it's 1 or 2, so that's why we need to add this code in. It's essential. Alright, that's it for this tutorial. I really hope you enjoyed. If you did, then smash like and smash subscribe. And in part 5, we're going to be making a boss battle, continuing some of the features that we made in this tutorial. I'll see you guys later, everybody. Goodbye!